What is up, guys? The LA Gamer here, and today I am bringing you guys episode 10, my MLB 17 The Show, Road to the Show series. Now, what I want to mention real quick is I am so pumped to play today. I'm actually really happy to play some Road to the Show today. I don't know if you guys ever been in one of those moods where you just watch a lot of baseball and you just have like a crazy temptation just to hop on and play some MLB The Show, but that's where I'm at right now. Look at my stat line. I'm tripling the second best guy in the league. For our league, and home runs. How am I not called up? I don't understand this, but while we're going to this next game, I was watching some, we're playing this next series. Let's see, we're playing Jacksonville. Batting third in the lineup as usual, but I was watching some clips, some interviews, things of that nature of some of the top prospects in MLB, guys like Alex Bregman, Dansby Swanson. I'm trying to think, just guys like that, you know, some of those guys that are drafted real high recently. And are making their MLB debuts very early on in their careers, and they're still really young. And I don't know, they give me the temptation to hop on this Road to the Show, because I feel like putting this guy in the MLB, I feel like it's about that time. We gotta get this guy to the MLB. I don't know why it's taking so long. The coach has not necessarily... We haven't gotten much recognition. That's basically what I'm trying to say. We haven't really gotten a whole lot of chances to prove ourselves. I mean, we're doing everything we can. I mean, when you think of baseball as a sport... it's not easy to get called up, but I feel like we're doing everything we can to this point, to be called up. We'll just have to, at this point, I guess it's more consistency than anything else. Right here, we're going to fly on that first pitch. Solid contact, though. The difficulty's still raised, something I mentioned last episode. Difficulty's still raised, still going to have some trouble here, crushing a ball, but I'm sure we'll figure it out. We're still playing second base also. But yeah, I'm assuming that since we had such a hot start, they're probably more concerned about us being consistent with how we're playing. Probably because we did so good to start, they probably think there's going to be a pretty heavy drop-off. And there probably will be, but even if we dropped off the face of the earth right now in terms of our our statistics, we'd still probably bat in 270 with, you know, 15 home runs a season. And as a rookie, that's pretty awesome. So, I'm trying to say, I mean, it doesn't hurt to call me up, you know? I don't mind it. If I batted 270 with 15 home runs my rookie season, I would not complain whatsoever. It's a pretty awesome stat line. I mean, the thing is, you get kind of caught up in these unrealistic stat lines ever since you saw, like, Trout come in his rookie season. I'm just mentioning him as an Angels fan. And the fact that he probably had one of the best rookie seasons in history. When Trout comes in there, his rookie season bats, like, 323 with some 30 home runs and 50 stolen bases, you know? You get this unreal impression that every rookie is like that. If you're supposed to, like, every star rookie is like that. I mean, he's one of the greatest players of all time already. So I got to come to this realistic expectation. Maybe batting 270 is something I need to be happy with, or something like that. I'm just saying that in terms of Road to the Show as a whole, I do that a lot. I get caught up in this idea that I got to hit like 40 home runs in my rookie season, which makes literally no sense. It just doesn't happen. If I look statistically at the number of players who've bat like over 310 as a rookie and had over like 300, 400 at-bats, I'm assuming it's not very many players. I think it's maybe like once every 5 years, once every decade, maybe somewhere around there. Probably even more rare than that. I think Corey Seager may have done it this year. I know Trout did it. Yeah, you know, I'm just kind of spitballing here. I'm just thinking about some of those guys. One thing though I also want to mention is wait, I thought I got under that ball. I did not think I hit a line drive, but there we go. Third baseman's gonna catch that liner, I guess. I did not see where that ball went, but where was I going? I was going somewhere with my train of thought, lost it very quick. Okay, turn two. Flip that ball faster. God dang it. That shortstop has no arm. This is why I'm telling the coach, dude, like, we have the best chance of winning with me at shortstop. I don't know why we have this dude, that dude right there playing shortstop. He doesn't know how to. Nah, pitcher, don't even worry about getting the ball. When you guys also commented discussing the idea of turning off the Showtime throwing meter, I may actually consider that. You guys said it would be a better indication of how hard my guy actually throws. I know I'm first pitch swinging this whole game, but This guy's throwing me fastballs right down the middle. So I feel obligated to swing at all of them. But yeah, when you guys were discussing the idea of turning off Showtime, I didn't want to do it immediately this episode until I discussed it, but if that sounds like a good idea, comment that down below, and I may actually consider doing that. Let's keep upgrading this contact. This contact versus our power versus lefty is very low. We gotta improve this. Still trying to improve this hitting. Slowly but surely, it's one of those things where, you know, upgrading the player is not supposed to be easy. It's supposed to be a slow process. The fact that we're even 80 overall at this age is ridiculous. Like, we are so ridiculously good for how early our Road to the Show player has been created. So let's see, runners on first. A runner on first, one out. Oh, that's double play ball. Not quite fast enough to run out those ones. If we got ourselves to about 80 speed, we'd be able to make some crazy plays. The 60 to 70 speed didn't make quite the impact I thought it would, but still, I do like the fact that we're faster. Speed's one of those things that I do really want to work on. Once we get to the show, once we get to the major leagues and we get our hitting stats where they need to be, fielding and speed will be the emphasis on our skills once again. It's kind of what I'm doing right now, is I'm going back and forth between hitting, fielding, and speed. Hitting, fielding, and speed. Just trying to make sure that my guy stays all around. I don't get too, like, unrealistically good at one area at one time. I mean, even right now, my fielding and arm strength is kind of unrealistic, but it's whatever. I enjoy it, so. There we go. First pitch swinging. I think all six of my at-bats this episode, I swung on the first pitch. And I'm 2-for-6 doing it, so I don't care. I'm going to keep doing it. Here we go. Chance to steal a base. 0-2 count. I'm assuming he's going to strike out. I'm going to just try to take this bag. Yeah, especially with that slow windup. That's an easy stolen base for me. Move on over to second. And put herself in a scoring position for a chance to be driven home. Another 0-2 count. You know what? I'm going. Oh, no. Didn't mean to do that. That's awkward. So 0-2 count again. Oh, he's actually gonna ground out. No. Get back. Okay. Don't know why my guy continued to run. I figured the game was gonna do that. I got really scared. Okay, two outs. I'm on third, top of the fourth. Still a 0-0 game. I'm just trying to score. As I mentioned before, actually one of my favorite things to do is be the one who actually scores, not the actual person that knocks in the RBIs, but the guy who gets the runs. If you know what I mean. I like scoring. I don't like knocking home runs. I like being the run that's knocked home. Because I think when I'm in the MLB, I'd rather lead the league in runs than lead the league in RBIs. Technically, it all comes back to, you know, it all makes the same impact. I just like being on base and moving around the bases more than swinging the bat. I think especially as a shortstop, it makes more sense to be that type of player. Shortstops aren't usually the type of guy that just knocks home tons of or home runs and RBIs. They're usually more the guys who have, when they're good hitters, they usually are more batting average speed and getting runs. Obviously, Troy Tulowitzki kind of didn't fit that mold. He used to get a lot of home runs and RBI, and that's kind of more what our build is after. But that's why we're giving ourselves a lot of power. I still want to have that pop. I just want to be able to get home a lot too on the base running side of things. But right there, another line out to shortstop. We haven't put a whole lot of pop behind the ball, so a lot of those balls are dying out in the infield. It's one of those reasons I'm focusing on upgrading that power. Really just trying to get that ball to the infield more than anything else. So we keep moving on here. A lot of chance here on the defensive end of things, the fielding side. Can't wait to be moved back to shortstop. Or at least have the discussion with my manager where I can tell him that, dude, I'm trying to be a shortstop. The thing is, I've been playing great at second base fielding-wise, so I'm pretty sure they're probably going to tell me that second base is the way to go for me, but I'm just going to tell them no. Once again, I'm going to tell them no. If they keep me at second base, I'm going to be pissed, because that's going to kind of ruin everything with my guy, but I don't think it's going to happen again. It just sucks. I do not want to be a second baseman when I make it to the major leagues. There we go. Knock back up the middle. There we go. Finally, we weren't first pitch swinging too. But another hit. We haven't got we haven't gotten too many huge hits this game, or this whole entire episode. A lot of singles, a lot of line drives. Like, I had a fast windup, I would have been thrown out. Okay, luckily though, he's gonna get a walk. Now it's first and second. A 2-2 count, hopefully this guy. I mean, just knock it out of the infield, just give us a chance to score a run. Oh, he's gonna strike out. Why was he bunting on a 2-2 count? And why would you pull back your bunt on a 2-2 count? So now an 0-2 count with Hideki Nishi up. I'm gonna try to steal third. Yep, he ain't gonna get me. There we go, we're gonna steal third on that good jump. Now it's second and third with two outs, because he's gonna strike out as well. And now a 1-2 count. Don't tell me he's gonna strike out the side with us on base. Just knock one of us home, come on. Let's see. Yes, he will knock me home. And it looks like, yeah, he's gonna try to score too. No, he's gonna stay at third. It looked like he's gonna try to score, but at least I'm gonna be able to score. That'll be the only run of the inning too. But here we go, chance for a double play. We now have a 2-1 lead with only a couple innings left. We make the double play here, we more or less will come out. We more than likely will come out of here and win the game. But no, he's gonna get a hit off of that pitch. So now runners on first and second, and they both have pretty high speed. So a little bit of a cause for concern here, but no, we'll come out of here with a win. Okay, yep, on to the next game. We won 2-1. Keep working on this guy's speed, 56 now. Trying to get those powers, like, or the power in contact, like I said, mid-60s, low-70s, before I worked on anything else. So in these next few episodes, you'll see a lot of upgrade points going into my hitting. But I'm sure you guys don't mind. I'm pretty sure hitting's kind of the more interesting thing anyways. So far in the series, we're 3-for-8, 3 singles. Not a very, not a lot of power, but that's all right. The pop will come. I mean, even last episode, there wasn't much power until we cranked a grand slam on the last app out of the inning, or the last app out of the whole entire episode, actually, to win us the game in the ninth inning. That was a pretty sweet swing. But, that's right. I think it makes more sense that way. I mean, a home run a series is still phenomenal. A home run every 5 games is still crazy, so. Oh! I hate it when pitchers go in that sidestep type of windup, too. All those things mess me up. I gotta have a consistent, like, release point out of the pitcher. There we go. Another nice ground ball, but that one's gonna stay on the ground, obviously, and we'll get pulled there on that double play. Another chance here up to bat. Tied 1-1, top of the fourth. Nobody on base. Just try to make a good swing on the ball. Once again, it's ground ball. That shortstop is killing me this game. This whole entire series has been killing me. I keep grounding out. This is something I mentioned in the last episode too that was upsetting me. Is the whole the idea that my guy is not getting any lift on the ball. Like, all I want is to just get the ball out of the infield, you know. Just, even if you get under it and fly out, I have more fun flying the ball out than grounding the ball out. It's more entertaining. I mean, you put the ball on the ground, you have a higher chance of getting a hit because it's more likely to seep to the infield than somebody dropping a fly ball. But, I don't know. Oh, we got lucky on that call. I'm just trying to just get a decent swing and put it in a gap or something. Just give me an extra base hit. But nope, once again on the ground of the shortstop. And we're going to continue this little streak of ground balls this episode. I think even the 3 singles we've gotten this episode have been ground balls. Just everything. Every single swing, ground ball. I'm going to have to activate fly ball hitter here in the next at-bat. Here we go. Double play chance. Shortstop will actually make a good throw there. And there we go. Double play ball. Moving on here. Top of the 8th. It's a good time to activate fly ball hitter. We got runners on first and second. If we put one in the air, we have a chance. If it goes long, we're going to tie the game back up. Not chasing that fastball. Here we go. God, okay. How the hell did the catcher catch that ball? That was frustrating. Okay. We're going 0-for-4 in that game. On to the next one. Yeah, we can't do any upgrades. not quite enough skill points. Like I said, now we're 33-10. Yeah, we've had a pretty big drop off in terms of win loss ever since about a few weeks ago. But now we're batting 360. It's dropped from 390 or so since we've upgraded the difficulty. Which makes sense. Still batting 360 is crazy. So I'm alright with it. There we go, back to back bowls, not chasing either of those ones. Ooh, that was a pitch to hit. I was a little bit late on that one. Throwing 93. Not throwing all that fast. Just I didn't expect three fastballs in a row. Four fastballs in a row. Okay, I'm going to swing on that one. Okay, the right fielder is going to have a minor seizure out there. Don't know what he was doing. He misplaced the ball, then jumps at nothing. Fine. This is what I was talking about, though. All I wanted was for us to actually put the ball in the air and give ourselves a chance to get an extra base hit. But let's just take a second here. Let's watch this right fielder. Oh, they're not gonna show him. Okay, whatever. I don't wanna bore you guys with that right fielder's fielding anymore, so I'll just not show it. But that was an interesting play by the right fielder. He's gonna get released from the team after that play. And this player's gonna strike out. So I'm not gonna score in this inning or off that at bat. So moving on here. Bomb the second, double play chance, one out. Oh, man. Just every single time that I see myself fielding second base, I just can't wait to be back at shortstop. All right. That third baseman, yeah, he's going to make the smart play. Throw it just directly over to first. That was definitely the right play there. Moved on here. Look at that. That whole entire batting oh god, a changeup. I did not expect that. After those four straight fastballs, that's what I was going to mention. The whole entire at-bat showed me four straight fastballs. Let's see what he brings to this at-bat. Oh, a fastball down the middle. I'm going to be a little bit late. Just swing right through it. Okay, let's see. We can make contact. Oh. That's a wild pitch. He's going to come home to score. There we go. We got lucky on that one. That'll give us a run. Now there's not quite as much pressure to knock him a run with us having the lead. Let's capitalize off that. Ooh. Should have just dropped my elbow a little bit and taken that. On a 1-2 count, we might as well try to get ourselves on base. Not swinging on that pitch. Even though it is a two-strike count, I'm still trying to be patient here. 3-2 count. Might work our way back and actually get a walk here. Let's see what we can do. Ooh, oh, I hoped on it too much. That was a pitch I should have swung at. But I think I got too nervous and was hoping for the walk, especially on a close pitch like that. Should have been aggressive. Wait, no, I wanted to catch the ball, not... What the hell? That was just stupid. We looked so stupid on that play. You know, whatever. Just moving back to shortstop and that won't happen. That's the strategy now. The one thing I don't like is now I'm getting used to playing second base. So when I move back to shortstop, it's going to be confusing again. That's the frustrating part. Because the controls are opposite, you know, you like move a certain way towards first, and it's opposite playing second base and all that stuff, especially on a double play. In one situation, you have to run left to the bag, other one, you have to run right to the bag, and just it's all instinctive, especially when you don't have a lot of time to make the play. All right, here we go. Keep moving on, top of the sixth here. Up 1-0. We're 1-for-2 on the day. They actually have a new pitcher in. We're going to get a hit off him, too. Back up the middle right there. See, that's where I don't mind if we keep the ball on the ground. As long as it goes back up the middle, that's almost always a hit. Almost any hit back up the middle is always going to be a hit, as long as you don't line it straight to the center fielder. Manager says steal base. Okay, don't tell me twice. Oh, that was a great stolen base. So... Moving on into the next inning, bottom of the sixth here, Chance on the defensive end of things. I think it's only the fourth game of the series, isn't it? So we still have one more game after this. Let's fire this on the first, another out. We really, ever since we upgraded our fielding, we have not really, I think, made an error. We've been a pretty phenomenal fielder. And that's what I want, like I said, trying to be a gold glover in the major leagues. That's one of the main goals. I'm all the way over here. Want to be a gold glover and a possible batting title player one year. MVP might come down the line, but batting title and gold glove would be the coolest things to get. Means you can, you know, hit the ball and field the ball. That's really kind of the primary criteria you're looking for when you get a shortstop. Hit the ball and field the ball. I guess that's kind of what you want from anybody who plays any position. Oh wait, that was an awful swing. We're not going to talk about the at-bat. I was too focused on talking. I didn't focus on the at-bat. Doesn't matter though. Bottom of the ninth, we're still up 1-0. And as long as our pitcher doesn't completely blow this game, we'll be fine. Nice little backhand grab right there. Fire on to first. Maintaining that streak with no errors. I'm liking it. And there we go. We are going to walk out of that game with a win. I think this is going to be the last game of the episode where upgraded contact versus righties. This should be the last game of the episode. I just realized we're playing the Jacksonville Jumbo Shrimp. That is their name. Interesting stuff. We're now batting 363. It's a pretty good average. It's a pretty phenomenal average, actually. I think honestly, my pace, I think if we could call up to AAA, we could probably bat 310. I think we got called up to the major leagues, we could probably bat like 270. That was a good grab by the third baseman. What I don't get is 270 in the major leagues is still, I think, what would you consider average? About 250? Is that about average, or is 270 about average? Either way, a 270 batting average as a rookie, I know would be above average. Well, okay, that was an interesting throw. So, I still think I'm quality enough to activate that perk to be called up. But obviously, I've maintained that belief all the way since day one. It's just that not much I can do because the manager. Oh my god, another line out. Okay. A line out's better than a ground out, but still, it's frustrating. I just want to get a hit. But the managers, obviously, they're tough to persuade in this game for some reason. They don't call you up regarding performance, I don't think. To be honest, I think I'd be batting like 260, and I still would have the same likelihood of being called if I batted 460. The thing is all about, the road to the show just bases off time, I think, more than anything else. Time and overall, more than performance. Well, I think performance makes more sense when you're using the logical side of things. I mean, in real life, there's no such thing as overall, there's just how you perform. So I think that if you have a top prospect and they're performing really high. Oh. That looked like it could have been a good swing. Just that I shouldn't have pulled that one. It was on the outside corner, my guy tried to take it to the left side of the field. But if you have a top prospect, he's batting 360. Call him up, you know? Because you shouldn't be concerned about his overall or any of that shit. You should be concerned about the fact that he's performing. Just like, I don't think there's any such thing as being called up too quick. Like, if you're destroying, like, I think there is if you're not, like, killing it, and then you're, like, forcing a person to be called up. I think that happens a lot in the majors. You just, like, force a person to be called up. But I think as long as you, you're performing the right way, there shouldn't be anything holding you back. Oh, there we go. We're going to get a lucky ground ball hit right there. The third baseman decides to dive over it rather than just playing it. So we're going to get hit right there. We've been making solid contact the whole episode. So luckily, we still have gotten a lot of training points this whole entire episode, regardless of the fact that we haven't gotten a lot of hits. That's the one benefit to I guess, make having ground balls are usually solid contact. Also, I was really going to play him at third base. Also, I was noticing when you think about our guy's skill set and the way he's been batting ever since I upgraded the difficulty, I'm actually going to be very similar to Dansby Swanson once I get called up. So it's still weird that the Braves drafted me when I'm like very similar to their shortstop. Because Swanson's one of those guys, you know, that's a pretty decent hitter, a great fielder. And he doesn't have a whole lot of pop, even though every once in a while he'll hit a home run. He's got decent speed. Like, he matches my guy's skill set pretty dead on. And once I make it to the major leagues, I don't think I'm going to have the same pop that I do here, especially ever since I upgraded the difficulty. It's pretty clear that my guy's lost a lot of his power. Anyways, here we go. That's the end of the series. This was a pretty quick episode. We got through it pretty quick because we had a lot of first pitch swinging and we didn't get on base a whole lot. So we'll see if our manager has anything to say. I mean, I always want to show you guys the end of the series, see if anything happens, see if we get any calls or call-ups or anything like that. Especially because, like I said in the last episode, I think a call-up might be coming pretty soon based off some of the discussions I've had with my manager. So, let's see. Oh, we're going to get a Marcell Ozuna. I don't mind that. Oh, here we go. We're going into the general manager's office. This is something. What could it be? Oh. Okay, well, this is mixed emotions. At least in the next episode, we will be a shortstop. We'll be looking to get you back into your original role going forward. Your versatility is a plus, though, and we will call on it when necessary. So, I guess I don't fully mind playing second base every once in a while. Yeah, I'll say it. I'm happy to switch back. I enjoy being a shortstop. Sounds like you know where you want to play. Do you want to talk to your coach about streamlining your development in that direction? Wait, what? Yeah, sure. What's this? I don't know what this is doing, but I guess we'll talk to a coach. Oh, it's this thing. I don't care about this. Okay, yeah, either way. If we look closely, yeah. When we look at our stats, we dropped back down to a 79 overall when we were an 83. I don't care a whole lot about that, though. What I care about is when we look at the lineup, we are now a shortstop. When we go into the roster, we are now a shortstop. 1 point behind Swanson. He's only batting 230 in the majors. That's what I'm saying. I mean, it doesn't hurt to call me up if he's not doing that great. He's got about the same amount of games and at-bats last season, so he's not performing quite at the same level as last season. But either way, if you look down, we actually are no longer on the first list of star players on this team. And if we look at the major leagues, our team is 5 games back. That's what I'm saying. While we're still early in the season, I want a chance to bring us into a playoff spot. But either way, if you guys enjoyed this episode, please click that like button below. Make sure to comment your opinion of the series and what I could do to make more interesting in the comment section below. And lastly, subscribe if you have not already to stay tuned to this series and other series I got going on my channel. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you guys next time. Peace out.